Hello, ladies and gentlemen, how are you? Welcome to Adult Education Ingredient. My name is Rosalia Wong. Guess what? Today I'm going to bring to you the topic called Technical Infrastructure, Intranets for Learners. First of all, let me define the meaning of Internet and Intranet. What are the difference between Internet and Intranet? As we all know, Internet means the public network. Intranet means cross network with a selection of groups of people. Now we know the differences between internet and intranet. Let me introduce today of my topic, which is study and research by Gilbert in 1998. So the term intranet is both refers to the technical infrastructures with means that the physical information made available through that infrastructure. So there are two technical aspects concerning intranets. The first one is a technical infrastructure, as we have introduced before. The second one is the performance and learning support. So I'm going to go through each one of them. The first one, technical infrastructure. Technical infrastructure refers to, it means that it's only available to specific users who has been authorized to access it. And the ease, it has ease of distribution, has ease of access, and it has a use of existing infrastructure. The second one is the learning and performance support. Here it means the review of the learning and performance resources and the computer-based training. There are some advantages of a performance and learning support system for both individual and organization concerning intranets. So what are they? So for individual, the advantages include something like access to information bases, and it is just in time on demand learning experiences, and it focuses on users' needs, and it has access to procedural guidance for job aids, job guidelines and checklists and so on. It has the collection of tools, templates and advice to support the performance. It reduced and the demand for money. It has the situated learning in the task context. What do you mean by situated learning here? Situated learning here means the individual acquire professional skills independently. Okay, what are the advantages of performance and support system for organizations? Here it means that it has the provide a consistent training, it has the reduced the travel cost, and it has procedural consistency. Procedural consistency here means the using the same method over and over again with consistent, and also it has rapid performance for novices. Here you may ask questions such as, what sort of advantages of intranet connections for novices? Okay, for novices, novices means, for anyone who don't know what does that mean, it means new user or the new occupants of the intranets. So much of that, also there are many advantages of the intranets, but there are some concerns issues as well. For example, information overload issues, the key characteristic that define the right performance support system. For example, performance centered design and the integration with working environment are neglected during resource development and overall system design. For example, also the unbridled development and lack of organization can create poorly and fragmented utilized resources. Also, for users issues, such as user may lack skill of choosing the appropriate resources, for example, organization policies, procedures, and culture, which can create unexpected barrier. So much for that. The successful intranets depends on, guess what? It depends on thoughtful initial assessment. It depends on a wide array of developmental expertise. It depends on the iterative evaluation and redesign, and also commitment to maintenance. And also it depends on the strategies that you use for training, how to use it, and also for example, the modification policies and procedures, and the alignment of individual and organizational incentives. That's all for me today. It is very short, but please do subscribe and like my channel and like my video, And until next time, thank you for listening and have a good day and goodbye.